Hey everybody, it's Mike the Vanagon Geek, and today we're sitting out here in the driveway in the heat, beautiful August afternoon, and we are installing a new stereo in Ferdinand the Van. This is a Boss, and I'll get you the model here in just a minute. My stereo took a dump, and we're getting ready to head on a road trip, so I picked this up. A little cheaper unit, but it's been getting good reviews, so we are going to put that in the van, and we'll see how it goes. So let's get at it. So here's the unit here. It's the Boss Audio Systems Elite, model number BE10. ACP-C is a 340 watt head unit. Just a media player. It does not play CDs. This particular one comes with the backup camera. It's obviously Bluetooth, all kinds of little features, all that stuff. But the cool thing is it's CarPlay and also compatible with Android Auto. Being an iPhone user, I wanted CarPlay so I can run Gaia and Maps and so forth. So apparently a lot of people have put this into their Vanagons and it fits pretty well. So I'm going to give it a try. These are a little less expensive. I picked this up from Crutchfield. And obviously there's more expensive models like Jensen and Kenwood and Alpine and so forth. But I don't drive the van every day and I don't want to spend $1,000 on an audio system that I don't really need. So I'm going to try this out, see if it works pretty good. And we'll see what happens. Just a little side note on Crutchfield. They have amazing customer service and I've bought multiple items from them over the years. If you have issues with problems, they're always eager to help. Their online chat's amazing. And just again, big shout out to Crutchfield for just being great service. So I highly recommend buying from them. All right, let's do it. So as you can see, I got the old stereo pulled out. I started connecting up a couple wires, got my constant. Vanagons don't have an accessory switch, so I've always had my stereo wired to this little guy right here. That's my accessory switch. I have four speakers in here. I've got them in the doors, these JVCs. I wired these tweeters into the stock locations. And in the back, can't really see them because there's a bunch of junk in here at the moment, but I got a couple 6x9s underneath the seat. This stereo does come with a backup camera. I don't think I'm gonna get that wired up today because I need an extension and I don't really need it that bad. So mostly just trying to get stereo working. So get these figured out and we'll put the plate in there, get her stuck in place and see how she works. So when you're doing wiring on your van, take the time to organize your wires. I had to slap a stereo in here on a moment's notice a few years back and I rushed it. And it was a mess and I knew it. And this time I'm taking the time to kind of go through and clean house a little bit, do a little housekeeping, replace some fittings and stuff. And one of the things you want to consider is the type of connections you use. I always use these heat shrink little butt connectors. Ooh, that's a hot heat gun. And I'll show you how those work here in just a second. And when you put your connectors on, after you crimp them down, make sure you do a little tug on them, make sure they're in there because they don't always connect, especially when you're connecting a larger wire to a little slightly smaller wire. So here's what the heat shrink looks like when it works. Electrical connectors basically grab onto the wire itself, not the insulation usually. So the heat shrink fittings, when they shrink down, they grab a hold of the insulation of the wire and they hold it in place so that there's no strain on the wire inside them. So that's why it's important to use heat shrink fittings. I use that on pretty much all fittings in my van. Just gives you a little extra peace of mind, but just make sure you check them, make sure they're solid, and make sure you shrink them down all the way. Hopefully you never have to mess with them again. All right, I got all my wires connected, and before I put the receiver part of the mount in there, I like to go ahead and just power it up, make sure it's working before I start mounting things. You can see it's stereo, I got the hood on it here. I'm gonna go ahead and flick that switch. Turns on the stereo and it's powering up. I still got the plastic on the screen, as you can tell. If all goes well, I should be able to get some sound out of it here shortly. Let's see how that works. All right, everything's working fine. I also like to fire up the engine and listen to it, make sure that not getting any huge whine. I think I've already got a noise suppressor built into this one, but anyway, so everything's working, and I'm gonna go ahead and get it installed into the dash, button everything up, and call it a day. Let's take a look. installed and ready to go.
We're ready for the road.
Say hi to my daughter.
Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Check me out on Instagram or even TikTok for maybe some fun van stuff, and we'll see you out on the road. Have a great day.